Hello, Nubis here, and welcome to another Minecraft video. And first, I gotta apologize. I did not mean to stay away for that long, but I had to wait for some software updates in order for me to even record. The old fraps with my new laptop just would not record. It kept crashing, so, well, I could play Minecraft, but I could not record. So, we're starting on our new S&N server. It's a private server, don't ask for the IP, but you know, if you do videos, send me a link to your channel. I'll check out your channel, and if me and Spiderman likes your work, we might invite you on. But again, don't be too sad if we don't. Alright, so me and Spiderman started this map about a week ago. Yeah, we're about a week in. Believe it or not, for some of the stuff that I'm going to show you, we're only about a week in. Okay, first of all, we did not do any quarries whatsoever. So all the resources we got are quarryless resources. So we just went out and proved that, oh, you don't need quarries in order to get all the resources you need. So, this is our entrance. We got a wrath furnace there. You just put a block of iron there and it turns it into dark iron. And then you stand here, and if you mine it this way, it'll pop that way. So you'll never have to stand in front of it and break it, and it pop back, so you get the dark iron block 100% of the time. This furnace here, miscellaneous bee stuff, don't know why a stone pick is there. I just did this. Spiderman doesn't even know about this yet. I went to a few villages and got some villagers so we could start our villager project. We are making, or in the end, we're going to have 100% of our floor be Zycorium blocks, because mobs don't spawn on Zycorium, so we don't have to worry about dark locations like this. Our blast furnace is making steel. I started that a little bit early. Our farm for food. For two of us, this is sustaining us. One thing I'm disappointed about these, Zycorium soil, you can't do potatoes on it. So I'm a little disappointed about that. If you're wondering what that is, if you ever go to one of those big wooden tower things in the, Twilight Forest, you can mine all those blocks. And I just mined some of these doors so I can place here, because I wanted this to be a dark area, like a dark, dark area. See, there you go, because our beds are in here, as you can see, and then our enchanting table area is in here. Right here goes an anvil, but I broke it, some books, and these are amber blocks, so it kind of makes that cool little thing. And of course, no lights, because don't need them with this Zycorium blocks floor. Alright, this is our crafting area. This is our one of our storage walls. We're slowly going to be moving over to ME storage. Like I said, we got a ton of blocks in there already. This is for our ores that we silk touched on my drill. I literally just made this drill and I've never used it for mining yet, so just pointing that out. Silk touch efficiency 4 or 5. What is that? 4 or 5? 5, yeah. I'm just going to demonstrate the sickness of this drill because you won't believe it. It insta mines every block. Not only insta mines every block, but silk touch insta mines every block. Yeah. Okay. This tank right here is going to be for our buffer, for our biofuel. I set this up last night. I didn't even have time to do that. I did these last night to a blast furnace. I wanted something over 1700 so we can do aluminum ingots, and not just the and not the zirconium aluminum ingots, which I found a use for those. I'll tell you in a minute. And then back here is our dust wall. I have a electrolyzer up here. We got MFEs running off of three thermal generators. Over here, don't ask me how it's doing it, but these two are using unlimited free power. They're not drawing any power. They're hooked up to the system. And I don't know if they're feeding off some of this Buildcraft power, but the Buildcraft power is not going down either. So I don't know how. But since I placed those down, they've been running off of them. They haven't been using any power. Because you can look. All these are fine. And with the GregTech machines, if they don't have 32 power, they won't work. And they're always working. Nothing's draining. So that's good. This is our machine row. We are going to move up closer to the surface. Portal gun. Now, the other day, we set up a system down here with force fields and stuff, and somehow the wither got out. Somehow the button got destroyed in a panic or something went wrong, and the force field went down, and yeah, he made a mess. But luckily, we killed him before he got up to our main area up here. And just to show you, no, we didn't go mining with quarries or anything to get the resources we got. Four stacks. We are playing on the Feed the Beast Ultimate server. Now, this is the Ultimate Pack. The hardest of the hardest. So, me and Spirion both felt that it is about that time in our gameplay that we need a challenge, and this was our challenge, and it's not posing very much of a challenge. This is from our mob grinder over here, which I'll get to in a second. Let's see if any books actually landed over here. We set this chest up. If any books landed in here, they're super very rare. So, enchants. 114 wither skull stacks. Yeah. You're reading those numbers correct. We only got three spawners. Three. We have a wither skull. We have a zombie pigman. What was the third one? Oh, and a blaze rod. Now, all this code is all the same. I'm going to show you two computers. And I'm just going to show you those. Just so you can see. Now, all this code is for I equals 1 to 100 attack. Attack 100 times in a row. Empty your inventory and then end. That's all that does. Reboot that. And we got a enchanting attacking turtle. Now, it has 200 levels. And this is a little bit different. No, I didn't mean to reboot there. We got a few different functions in here. First, we wrap the peripherals. We set the auto collect to true, so automatically, we don't even have to tell it to collect. We got a function here that says find book. Pretty much, it takes a book here. If that's a book, or whatever item is there, it's going to place one of them there. So you see it, a book, a bone is there, so it placed one bone there. Because you can't tell it what items are what. Okay. So, now it's going. Now this is enchant books. Enchant books call that find books right there. Okay. Now, if that enchant it correctly, it will just exit out of there. If not, it's out of books. It can't enchant the bone, so it's out of books. So, simple as that. Okay, right here is the main loop. These two clears the screen, set the cursor in there, so you don't have a continuous line of text going down. It's always updating the same row, same time. It's just printing the levels. Okay. Right there, selects the second slot, sucks everything in front of it, and for 15 loops, it will select these 15 right there and drop whatever item's there. And then attack between each select. So it's fast. And then at the end of the loop, it tries to enchant. Can't. Oh well. And that's basically that. We can turn it on for a few seconds just so you can see it all work. We don't like to keep it on because we don't really need any resources. If I stand like right here, I can suck some of the XP up. So the auto collect is slow enough so we can still get it, but it's fast enough so you never leave anything behind. Up here is our tree farm. Oh. Up here is our tree farm. Basic forestry tree farm, or railcraft tree farm. You can see it's full. So that it's basically supplies all of our trees. I set that up the other day. Again, we're only about a week into this map. And for all the future projects, I think I'm going to take you along. Over here, I got a couple industrial centrifuges hooked up to our ender tank here, which has a ender tank pump and four redstone and another pumping lava into our system. This supplies our MJs right now. We got two energy cells, one right there feeding the machines up here. This right there doing just extra power. And lava feeds into our industrial centrifuges, and it runs constantly making copper, electrum, tin, and tiny piles of tungsten, and we got two of them. Here is a start of the power system I had designed. I'm gonna move this to this room back here, because this is actually going to be the power room once I get done fixing it. Down here is our mines. I'm not even going to show you. I could show it to you, but it's our regular strip mine. Normal method. Again, we didn't use anything to mass mine yet. So that is just, that's about it with the server tour. There's nothing really much in here. Too much. We are still laying the foundation to our base. Again, we're building up. So all this stuff here might move to the surface because we want to build up on the surface, not down in the ground. Anyway, I'm going to start trying to release regular videos at least once every couple of days and get back on track. Again, I apologize for my absence. I really had to wait for the next version of Fraps to get released because Fraps kept on crashing and it was a known bug, but I had to wait till Fraps crashed it because my old computer died on me, the one I used to record, it literally just the power supply caught on fire. Yeah, so So I lost that whole entire computer. Ruined the hard drives and everything. I think I kept like 2 sticks of RAM that was in it, but it's no big deal. So I'm on my laptop now. I tried a few different other optional recording methods, but they kept on just freezing and reducing the frame. And I don't get very good frame rate on here as it is. So again, it's a laptop. What I have on me now: nano boots, nano leggings, nano helmet, and a advanced jetpack. That is about it. We did go to the Nether, We did go to the Trilight Forest. That's a magic map. We didn't do very much into Mistcraft yet. We did go to a few worlds to get some Mistcraft pages, because the best method to get Mistcraft pages is actually to go to a random Mistcraft age and just walk around. If it's stable enough so you can stand it, just walk around until you find the Mistcraft libraries. Anyway, take it easy and look forward to recording for you guys again. Thanks.